Good morning everyone. Today we are going to start the chapter number 1, that is real numbers. But first of all, let us revise few things. The first collection of numbers is natural numbers that starts from 1 and goes to infinity. Next, if we include 0 in the natural numbers, then this collection is called the whole numbers. Next are integers. Integers include all the negative numbers along with the whole numbers. Next are rational numbers. Rational numbers are those numbers which can be written in the form of p by q, where p and q are integers, q not equal to 0, and HCF of p and q is 1. That means p and q are coprime. Next are irrational numbers. All those numbers which are not included in rationals, that is they have non-terminating, non-repeating decimal expansion, are included in the irrational numbers. Next are real numbers. So basically real numbers is the collection of all the rationals and irrational numbers. So all these numbers, natural, whole, integer, rational and irrational, they are all included in the real numbers. Next is Euclid's division lemma. So Euclid's division lemma states that let there are two positive integers a and b such that a is greater than b, then there exist unique q and r such that a is equal to bq plus r, where r lies between 0 and b. So if we divide a by b, then q will be the quotient and r will be the remainder. So we can write a, that is called the dividend, equal to b, b is called the divisor, q is called the quotient and r is the remainder. So a is equal to bq plus r. And this remainder r always lies between 0 and b. Let us understand by taking an example. If we divide 13 by 4, then the quotient is 3 and the remainder is 1. So we can write 13 as equal to 4 into 3 plus 1. Here 3 is the quotient and 1 is the remainder. And we can see that the remainder 1 lies between 0 and it is less than the divisor. Next, if we divide 14 by 4, the quotient is 3, remainder is 2. Again, 14 is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder, and remainder is greater than 0 and less than 4. If we divide 15 by 4, the remainder is 3 and it is again less than 4. And now if we divide 16 by 4, the quotient is 4 and the remainder is 0. So in these four cases we can see that the remainder is either equal to 0 and it is always less than the divisor. Next is Euclid's division algorithm. An algorithm is a fixed procedure to solve a problem in which we have various steps we follow. So Euclid's division algorithm states that let a and b be two positive integers such that a is greater than b. So in step 1 we apply Euclid's division lemma on a and b, which states that a is equal to bq plus r, where r lies between 0 and b. Now if r is equal to 0, then the smallest of these two numbers is the HCF. So if r is equal to 0, then HCF of a and b is b, because a is greater than b. If r is not equal to 0, then we go to step number 2. In step 2, we again apply the division lemma on b and r. Now the previous divisor becomes the dividend and the previous remainder becomes the divisor. So now a will equal to b and the previous r will become b. We will repeat this process till the remainder is 0. The divisor at the last step is the required HCF. So let us understand this by taking an example. So we have to find HCF of 4 and 60. So now we can see that 60 is greater than 4. So we will take A as 60 and B as 4. Now if we divide 60 by 4, the quotient is 15 and the remainder is 0. So we can write 60 equal to 4 into 15 plus 0. So now we can see that if r is equal to 0, then the HCF is the smallest number. So here r is 0, so the smaller of both the numbers is the HCF, that is 4. Now Second example, here we can see that 455 is greater than 42. So A is equal to 455 and B is equal to 42. So in step 1, apply Euclid's division lemma, which states that when we divide 455 by 42, the quotient will be 10 and the remainder will be 35. So now we can see that R is equal to 35, which is not equal to 0. So we have to jump on the next step, that is step number 2. Now the previous divisor will become dividend and previous remainder will become the divisor. So we will divide 42 by 35, the quotient will be 1 and the remainder will be 7. Now again we can see that R is equal to 7, not equal to 0. So we have to again apply Euclid's division lemma. So here now the previous divisor will become dividend and previous remainder will become the divisor. So here 35 is equal to 7 into 5 plus 0. So here we can see that the remainder is 0. So when the remainder is 0, the divisor in this step will be the HCF. What is the divisor here? 7. So here HCF of 455 and 42 is equal to 7. So by this we can find HCF of any two numbers. Next example is, show that every positive even integer is of the form 2q and that every positive odd integer is of the form 2q plus 1. That means an even integer can be written in the form of 2q, where q is some integer, and odd number is written in the form of 2q plus 1, where q is some integer. So let us suppose, let A be any positive integer and take B is equal to 2. So we will apply Euclid's division lemma on A and B, which states that A is equal to BQ. B here is 2, that means 2Q plus R, and this R lies between 0 and it is less than the divisor B. So here we can take values of R equal to 0 and 1. So if we put R equal to 0, then A will become 2Q plus 0, that means 2 into Q. And we all know that if we multiply 2 by any number, the resultant is always a even number. So which is even. If R equal to 1, then A will become 2q plus 1, that means this number will be a odd number, because 2 into q is even, and if we add odd number in a even number, the resultant is odd. So which is odd. So here we can see that if R equal to 0, the resultant is even. If R equal to 1, the resultant is an odd number. So therefore, any even integer is of the form 2q and odd integer is of the form 2q plus 1 and q is some integer. Let's start exercise 1.1. Here in the first question we have to find the HCF of 135 and 255. So we will solve this by Euclid's division algorithm. Here we can see that 255 is greater than 135. So we will take A is equal to 255 and B is equal to 135. So according to algorithm, in first step we have to apply Euclid's division lemma. So 255 will equal to 135 into 1 plus 90. If we divide 255 by 135, the quotient is 1 and the remainder is 90. So here r equal to 90, not equal to 0. So we will jump to step number 2. In step 2, again apply Euclid's division lemma on 135 and 90. The divisor in the first step and the remainder in the first step. So this will become 135 equal to 90 into 1 plus 45. Here r equal to 45, again not equal to 0. So again apply Euclid's division lemma on 90 and 45. So 90 will be equal to 45 into 2 plus 0. So here we can see that remainder is 0. So when the remainder is 0, the divisor in that step is the HCF. Here 45 is the divisor, so therefore HCF of 255 and 135 is equal to 45. So by this algorithm we can find HCF of any two numbers. Next question, here the greater number is 3820, so we will take A as 38220, B will be 196. So step number 1, apply Euclid's division lemma, which states that A is equal to BQ plus R. R lies between 0 and B. So 38220, when divided by 196, the quotient is 195 and the remainder is 0. So in the first step, we found that r equal to 0. So the smaller of these two numbers is the HCF. So HCF of 38220 and 196 is 196. Next question, 867 and 255. So A will be 867 and B will be 255. So step number 1, apply Euclid's division lemma. So 867 will be 255 into 3 plus 102. So here r equal to 102, not equal to 0. So apply Euclid's division lemma again. So this will become 255 equal to 102 into 2 plus 51. So here (51 ) (0). So apply EDL again. So 102 equal to 51 into 2 plus 0. So r is equal to 0, therefore HCF of 867 and 255 is the divisor in the last step, that is 51. So by this algorithm we can find HCF of any two numbers. Now the second question is, show that any positive odd integer is of the form 6q plus 1 or 6q plus 3 or 6q plus 5. So we have to show that any odd integer can be written in the form of 6q plus 1, 6q plus 3 or 6q plus 5. So let us suppose A be any positive integer and B equal to 6. So by Euclid's division lemma, A will be equal to BQ plus R. So this will become A is equal to 6q plus r, where value of r lies between 0 and it is less than 6. So we can take 6 values of r, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So we will put the value of r one by one. So if r is equal to 0, then A will become 6q plus 0, that means 6q. So we can write 6 as 2 into 3. So as we all know, if we multiply 2 by any number, the resultant is even. So 2 into 3 cube, this will be an even number. If r equal to 1, then A will become 6q plus 1. So we can write it as 2 into 3 cube plus 1. So 2 into 3 cube, that means even into any number is even, and if we add 1 in even, the resultant is odd. So this resultant will be odd. So that means A is equal to 6q plus 1 will be a odd number. If r is equal to 2, then A will become 6q plus 2. Here we can take 2 common, this will become 3q plus 1. So we all know that 2 into something is always even, so this resultant is even. Next, if r equal to 3, then A will become 6q plus 3. We can write it as 2 into 3q plus 3. 2 into 3q is even, and even plus odd is always odd. So this is a odd. If r is equal to 4, then A will become 6q plus 4. We can take 2 common here, so which is again even, because 2 into any number is even number. If r is equal to 5, then A will become 6q plus 5. So we can write it as 2 into 3q plus 5. This part is even, even plus odd is odd, which is odd. So here we can see that in 3 steps we found the number odd. This r equal to 1, this is also odd, and this is also odd. So therefore, any positive integer can be written in the form of 6q plus 1, 6q plus 3, or 6q plus 5, where q is any integer.